Hi, I'm Gemma Allen. In the wake of the Harvey Weinstein scandal and the revelations of a culture of sexual abuse in the entertainment industry, the perpetrators and those who protect them have found themselves in the spotlight over the use of non-disclosure agreements, otherwise known as NDAs. These agreements intend to buy the silence of the victim, but unfortunately, they can also arguably protect serial perpetrators. DNAs are under attack because they shield the perpetrators from criminal prosecution, thereby allowing them to seek new victims. Often it is the accused, however, who wants the silence, but we must remember sometimes it is also the accuser who settles in order to have financial compensation for their abuse so they can afford to get on with their lives and get therapy without years of uncertain litigation and public scrutiny. The consequences of breaking an NDA is really a calculated risk that can result in the loss of settlement money and give the defendant the right to sue. There are some protections already in place for those who do not want to be silenced. States like California prohibit the use of confidentiality provisions if they involve potential crime. Some states prohibit such agreements if they conceal certain facts. But we cannot ignore the reality of the fear and intimidation that comes with publicly exposing victims. By passing laws that ban all NDAs, we actually risk marginalizing rather than empowering the very people we're trying to protect. What matters most is that women and men who experience sexual harassment feel free to seek justice, whether they choose to go public or not. I'm Gemma Allen. Thanks for watching. See you next time.